Some people say our memories are what makes us who we are. We start out as big as a block of granite, and our experiences chip away at that block, one little chunk at a time, until every joy, every victory is carved out forever. Every tragedy, too. Some memories are so beautiful you have to hide them from the sun for fear that they might start to fade. And others? Others, you wish you could reach into your brain and pull from your head. You wish you could reattach that chunk of granite that was chipped away from you forever. But what if memory wasn't permanent? What if a procedure or a pill could erase that terrible tragedy, wipe out that ache in your heart, and make you whole again? Would you take that pill? Would you change who you are? Professor McGill put down his book and closed his eyes.
I like how you changed that last part.
It's better.
It's brilliant. It's just so...
I think this is the best thing I've ever written.
It is so good to hear you say that.
Really?
Yeah. Because you're going to have to live with it when it hits the bestseller list.
What are you talking about?
Spaulding's publishing arm. I gave your pages to Alan. He loved them. He wants to buy the book. You're going to be published, Coop. You're going to be famous.
Alan, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
How's the research coming?
What research?
Just kidding, Mr. Spaulding. A little, memory science humor.
Ooh. I'm not laughing and I'm not...
funding your lab for entertainment value.
Sorry. It's just that...
I'm in a very good mood today. I think we've made a
breakthrough.
Ah, that's the kind of news I want to hear, Doctor. Because what you've created could help millions of people... eliminate their painful memories.
Well, there still are a few kinks to work out, and currently it's only been successful in the gaseous form, but we're very close.
This drug could make us billions. To think it all began with this silly little book of Henry Bradshaw.
You really think that
many people will want to erase memories?
We all have something in our life we want to forget.
Lizzie.
Hey, sorry, I was just watching that mother with her baby. You think she's older than Sarah, or older than Sarah would have been?
I don't know, Lizzie.
It's not like I come here to...
It's okay. I do the same thing. Every girl in her 20s is Tammy to me.
Just... really never stops hurting, huh?
I wouldn't know. I gotta get home to Josh. I'll see
what if you could make it stop? I mean, what if you could get rid of the pain? Would you want that?
Where to, Mr. Spaulding?
I thought Bruno was driving me today.
I think Bruno had an appointment to get his knuckles waxed. Your sister asked me to fill in.
Fill in and report on my schedule, I bet.
I just drive.
Then drive.
Hello, Beth.
Oh, what are you doing? Alan, let go of me!
Come with me. Come with me. drive, Cyrus.
You all right, Beth?
Please, Beth, just let me give you a ride.
Why? Why should I?
Because your baby's future depends on it.
Oh, Alan, is that a notebook for a birthing class?
Just hear me out.
It's okay, Cyrus. You can go.
Trust me on this, Beth. It's very important. Now, if all goes well, all the bad things that have happened in your life can be forgotten forever.
Look, hey, stop.
What?
I'm not signing anything without my lawyer, though.
You have a lawyer?
Okay, I'm not signing anything until I get a lawyer.
Okay, let's just see what Alan's offer is first, okay?
Okay, fine. Fine.
Hey. Oh, I thought he'd be in by now. I told him that I was going to be bringing you by.
Ah, well, maybe he changed his mind about helping out Cooper.
No way. Come on, look, I know that he was excited, and I know that he was,
What?
Nothing.
What?
Hey,
what is
deal.
It?
Nothing.
What would you... Thank you. Hey. Avery, do you know what this is? Alan didn't buy my book to help publish it. He wanted my ideas, my research to wipe out people's memories.
I love Tammy. I always will. I never want to let her go.
Of course not.
And I'm doing better.
How much better?
Well, going on with my life. I'm going to marry Josh soon.
But you haven't married him yet.
No.
And you don't feel normal yet.
No.
Is that okay? Is it okay to think that you may never feel normal ever again?
Well, I guess I can't carry this pain around with me forever. I mean, it wouldn't be fair to RJ or Josh.
I think that there's someone that might be able to help us.
Family.
Destiny.
Light. Hope.
Charity.
Friendship.
Love.
Faith.
Laughter.
Joy. Kindness.
Understanding. Peace.
Forgiveness.
Happiness.
Freedom.
There is a destiny that makes us brothers.
None goes his way alone.
All that we send into the lives of others
comes back into our own.
Help you?
Remy?
You work here?
Yeah, a couple hours here and there. It's an easy gig.
Did they assign you here from the house?
What are you talking about?
This place, this is a lab funded by Spalding, by my granddad. Okay, we have to get in here.
Do what you want, I'm quitting. I don't help Alan Spalding make money.
Do you know what they do here?
What I do know is you don't want to be a part of this, Cassie. Whatever Lizzie's up to, you should just walk away. As a matter of fact, I'll take you home.
I've come this far. No.
Can I get the door for you?
Just leave the car running. This won't take long. Come
with
me,
Lizzie's, Beth. That's Lizzie's car.
What?
Lizzie is here.
That's impossible. She doesn't know about this place.
This place? What the hell is going on here?
Listen, don't worry about it, all right?
But you're worried. Why wouldn't you want Lizzie here?
You better tell the lady, Mr. Spalding. You wouldn't want to upset her in her condition.
Come with me, Beth.
I think it's locked.
Yeah, thanks. I got that. Okay, find something to bash the door in with.
So much for trying to talk our way in.
Okay, you promised that you weren't going to bail on it.
I'm not.
Look out.
Yes.
Not a good idea.
Why are you still here?
I don't want Cassie to get any more messed up.
Thank you. I'm fine.
If you were fine, you wouldn't be here.
Do you have keys to this?
I'm not helping you do this.
Then why do you care?
Because I have enough
on
my conscience, okay?
The door is triple locked. You're not getting in. You'll hurt yourself.
Okay, thank you for the warning.
What's your call, man? I'm going to the bathroom. If you're by my car, great. If not...
Look out!
What do you mean, erase bad memories? What... You think that Lizzie found out what you were up to in this place? You think that she wants to try this drug?
There's still some kinks to be worked out, Beth, but
if anything happens to her, so help me God.
What are you doing here?
It was my idea, wasn't it?
Anybody home? Looking for a brain in a jar. I don't know, Tammy.
Hello? I was just looking for Beth. Whoa, that looks bad.
Hey, you guys, have you seen Coop? Oh, no!
Open this damn door!
I'm not meant to.
Okay. Hey there.
Hey. What's going on?
I don't know. It looks like we fell asleep together.
And who are you?
Who am I?
Yeah.
I don't know.
You don't know who you are?
I just can't think of it right now.
It's okay. I'm sure it'll come to you. It's fine. And who are you?
Who am I? Who are you?
I don't know.
What are you doing?
I don't know. You're on top of me.
Why would I be on top of you? I don't even know you. I'm not sure either.
What is this? I have no idea. I have no idea how I got in here. I don't know my name. I don't know how I... Is this a men's room? Oh, gross.
Look, I don't know any more than you do.
Whoa.
You don't think that we just...
We are alone in a office bathroom, and that's what we were gonna do.
Why wouldn't I remember that?
I don't know. You're hot, though.
Yeah, you too.
We're kind of a good-looking couple.
Yeah.
And it's kind of kinky, you know? Doing it in the bathroom.
That's what I was thinking.
My clothes are nice. This must be my purse, which looks like it costs like $1,000. Okay, so I must be rich. That's cool. You're a security guard. Okay, my parents must hate this.
How is it possible that not one of us remembers who we are or how we got here?
Well, this is my driver's license, and it says I'm Alan Spaulding. But that doesn't sound familiar at all.
Henry Cooper Bradshaw.
Ooh, that's a big name.
Yeah.
What do you think you go by?
I think Hank. You look like a Hank to me.
Hank.
Mm. Yeah, that's
Hank.
It.
Yeah.
Okay. Hank.
Thanks.
Yeah. I am Elizabeth Spaulding.
Wow.
We must be related.
Yeah, maybe he's your father.
Yeah. Yeah, that makes sense. Mm-hmm. Hey, Dad.
Hello, Elizabeth.
And it is... Nice to meet you, Hank.
Nice to meet you. Whoa, who do you think that is?
Oh, wow. Whew. I'm pregnant.
Wow, that's incredible. Then I'm going to be a grandfather then, huh?
Whoa.
What is it, Hank?
I must have been carrying this book. I think I'm going to be a dad.
Well, I know one thing. We all have interesting names. Really weird names.
Ava's not weird.
Cassandra.
Fine. So just Cyrus and I have interesting names. That's cool.
Is it?
I think so.
We also know we're in some kind of laboratory, which probably explains how we ended up where we did.
And we know that you and I are together. Yeah, because I woke up in your arms.
Wait a second. I woke up in his arms.
No. You were leaning up against him like a big old redwood that got struck by lightning.
Okay, you left-handed or right-handed?
Well, let me check. I'm a lefty.
There you go. I was on his left side, which means he was holding me with his strong arm.
Or he was holding me with his right arm so his left arm could be used for more important...
You are a tramp!
Hey, ladies. Let's not fight. My accent's Australian, which means I probably have some of the adventure in my blood.
I love Australian guys.
Lucky me. But we should really try and figure out exactly what we did to ourselves so that we can fix it.
Oh, I'm sure you'll figure it out. You seem like a very smart guy.
Oh, thank you. Maybe there's some other people in this building, like scientists.
Well, maybe we're the scientists. We're in a lab, right?
Do we look like scientists to you?
Well, she definitely doesn't.
Ah! And what are you, the blonde Einstein?
My hair is natural, thank you very much.
How do you know?
Let's start a search of the building. We should split up.
Fine. I'll go right, Ava can go left.
We'll check the other floors, then meet back here in 15 minutes.
Fine.
Fine.
I'll miss you.
I'll miss you both.
I'll miss you! Hi!
What happened to splitting up?
I did go off on my own for a little while, but it's kind of embarrassing. I got a little scared.
Scared of what?
This whole thing, it's just really weird. You know, not knowing who I am, not knowing who to trust.
You can trust me.
I get that. I do. You know, it's really weird. I keep getting these, like, little flashes.
Flashes?
Flashes of you and I on the beach. Flashes of you and I at a fancy restaurant. All kinds of things.
You don't say.
It was good, Cyrus. I can tell you that much.
I don't doubt that at all.
Cassandra?
Wait!
Think we ever did that?
Of course. I love horses.
You love horses?
Yeah, don't you?
Yeah. Yeah, I think I do love horses.
That is so great. So, what's your favorite color?
Blue.
I love blue. Oh my God, okay, this is so crazy. We're so lucky that we found each other.
In the men's room?
No, I mean before. We're really lucky that we were in love.
You think we were in love?
I feel this ache in my heart. I think that's what it means.
I feel the same way.
You always were the best kisser.
Always?
Okay, I'm trying to play the part, you know, because then maybe it'll help us remember.
Okay, so what else do you want to do on our office chair date?
Well, whatever knocked us out made me really thirsty, so find me a soda.
Find you a soda?
Yeah, just go to the machine and get me a diet soda.
Hey, first of all, how about a please, and how would I know where to find a soda?
You are the night watchman?
I do security.
Okay, same difference.
To you, maybe, with all your money.
Do you need money for the machine? Is that the problem?
You think I can't afford a soda just because I work for a living?
No, I was just saying that I'm sure I probably pay for
it. I'm a man, Elizabeth Spaulding. You can't buy me, okay?
I wasn't trying to say that.
You know what? Find your own soda. I'm gonna get my memory back. Maybe I'll remember what I ever saw in you.
So when do you think we're due?
Just a few months.
Oh, God. That is incredible. You think it's a boy or a girl?
I don't care. As long as it's healthy and as long as it's yours.
Hank, you look a little young to be married to my daughter.
Well, I don't think it's about age. I know I'll be a good father.
How can you be so sure of that when you don't even know what your own address is?
Back off, Dad.
I'm just looking after the welfare of my grandchild. Speaking of welfare, what do you do for a living?
I don't know. Well, what do you do for a living?
Well, the card in my wallet says that I'm a CEO of Spaulding Enterprises. While the cards in your wallet say that you're a member of the public library, also Sammy's Sandwich Club member, and it looks like if you get one more punch, you'll get a free sandwich.
Oh, boy, does that sound good. I really get the munchies.
Yeah?
What do you say? Who says I can't provide for my,
Wait, you bring up an interesting point there, Hank. I noticed that you're not wearing a wedding band. That means you two may not be married.
Well, I'm wearing a ring, so maybe Hank didn't want to wear a ring. Some men don't. What's the matter with that?
Well, it matters to me, and I'm sure it matters to your mother.
I don't remember my mother.
I don't remember your mother either, but I'm sure that she would not approve of Henry Cooper Bradshaw.
Hey, do you think I'm related to Terry Bradshaw?
Football! What a surprise!
Look, Mr. Spall. Al. Dad. There is a baby on the way. Now, he or she is going to need all of us.
All of us, Dad.
Look, why don't we just take the elevator and go upstairs? We'll go to the offices and see if we can find out why we can't seem to remember anything.
That's the first sensible thing you've said.
Where are we going?
Come on. Come on.
So good.
I'm glad you like it.
No, I mean, it feels so good to not remember. I don't know how to explain it, but I feel like before something was weighing me down, and now...
Now you're free?
Yeah. Like I can finally just let go.
And let go, Cassie.
You wanted, and I don't blame you, but you know what? Oh, yeah, you had to corner him in this room so he wouldn't find out.
Find out what?
Look what I found in your bag. Who's the guy in the beard?
I have no idea.
Cheating tramp?
Jealous bitch?
Give me that! Give me that photograph!
That's
give
it to me.
Give me the... Give me the... No! That's my photograph!
Liz, I'm sorry I jumped all over.
No, I'm sorry I said all those things. I didn't even mean them. I just needed caffeine. I missed you. Really?
Really. Sorry, can we...
Okay, all right. We need to get a new place.
Good idea.
I hate when we fight.
Me too.
Why don't I like it when we make up? Mm.
Mr. Spaulding!
You know me?
Of course I know you. You're the... We have to go. The gas got out in the building.
The gas?
We developed a drug that would help people forget the... Never mind. You'll remember soon.
I don't remember anything.
I know. But we haven't been able to make the effects last. It wears off after a couple of hours.
Thank you.
picture.
What were we doing?
Fighting over me.
I'm so embarrassed.
I'm really embarrassed.
What was I thinking?
You didn't remember anything.
Oh, I mean, what was I thinking coming here? I mean, did I really think I wanted to forget? Did I really think I'd be happier if I wiped out all those memories?
I'm really sorry for your loss. And mine.
Thank you. You're sweet. You could have taken you.
I know.
Can you believe that somebody is going to be small enough to wear this?
Well, not just somebody.
Our somebody.
I'm sorry. Yeah. I don't think anybody saw.
No.
I mean, not that you're.
No,
you look,
no, not, no, what, not, you know, not for at someone, all. It's,
maybe we should get back to Alan.
Yeah, let's. Alan. Let's
yes.
Do that.
Okay. Sorry. You know what? You can keep the clothes that I bought.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Thanks. Thanks, Hank. I mean, I'm... Poop?
Mrs. Spaulding.
Okay.
Holy sh...
Well, you two have come back.
Yes, Alan, we're back in every way.
Ah, then you realize that...
we realize.
Yeah, we went for a walk, and as soon as we hit the fresh air, the drug wore off.
That quickly?
Yep. Would you think we went shopping for our baby?
come on, Alan, let's go find Lizzie, make sure she's okay.
You will never, ever talk about this ever again.
Fine with me.
I'm serious, Lizzie.
Okay, it's not like it's exactly good for my reputation either, right?
We weren't ourselves.
Yeah, not at all.
I mean, like, we have nothing in common, you know? I mean, we don't even like each other. Okay, so let's just keep our distance and act like this never happened.
We both like blue.
What's going on?
I never want to forget. No matter how hard it gets, I never want to forget.
You know, I don't think I want Spaulding to publish my book.
Really?
Trust me. It's for the best.
If it's our memories that makes us who we are, then what would we become if we suddenly lost them? who would we be? Who are you without the warm comfort of past joy or the searing pain of loss and regret? Who is that slab of marble? If you could wipe the slate clean, would you do it? Would you start over? Would you erase all the hurt? All the mistakes? Would you clear it from your mind? And clear it from your heart? I don't think so, he said. You hold on. You hold on to those memories, bad and good. You hold on for dear life. Because that's what they are. Life.
This has been Guiding Light.